Hello friends, I am Sudhir and you are enjoying the YouTube channel English Carnival, a journey of learning with joy. Friends, today we are going to explore some multiple choice questions based on Oliver Goldsmith's popular prose called National Prejudices. But friends, as usual, before we proceed, I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this channel in the coming days. Friends, here, Oliver Goldsmith was no doubt an extraordinary poet, essayist, dramatist, novelist, and prose writer as well. Friends, he is considered as one of the greatest writers of 18th century. Friends, he is also best known for his novel like The Vicar of Wakefield, his pastoral poem The Deserted Village, and his plays like The Good-Natured Man and She Stoops to Conquer. Friends, in this prose called National Prejudices, Oliver Goldsmith argues that it is possible to love one's own country without hating the natives of other countries. He says that it is good that people have good opinions about their own countries and they love their own countries very much. But at the same time, we should not think in a negative way about the people of other countries without meeting those people personally. Here, friends, we can understand others only, or he says that we can understand others only when we live with them. He appreciates the English people and says they are brave and generous and at the same time rash, headstrong and impetuous. He also talks about the Dutch, French, Germans, Spaniards, people and their different facts. He also talks about the term called patriotism and puts his comments about the same in this prose. So friends, I'll definitely prepare a separate video containing the brief summary and crucial threads of this prose for you all in coming days. But today, let us move and see around 25 to 26 multiple choice questions based on Oliver Goldsmith's well-known prose, National Prejudices. So friends, let us move. We have the first question. Oliver Goldsmith was a or an Dutch novelist, playwright, essayist and the poet. Options are A. American, B. Anglo-Irish, C. Russian and D. British. The correct answer is B, and he was an Anglo-Irish novelist, playwright, essayist and the poet. Question number 2, we have Oliver Goldsmith was born on dash. Options are A, November 10, 1728, B, November 10, 1738, C, November 11, 1728 and D, November 11, 1738. The correct answer is A, and he was born on November 10th, 1728. Question number 3 we have, Oliver Goldsmith's essays appeared in the form of dash. Options are A, proceedings, B, novels, C, letters, and D, pamphlets. The correct answer is C, and that is letters. Question number 4 we have, Oliver Goldsmith's essays published as dash. Options are A, National Prejudices, B, The Citizen of the World, C, The Good-Natured Man, and D, None of These. The correct answer is B, and it is The Citizen of the World. Question number 5 we have, in the first line of the prose itself, the narrator calls himself as dash. Options are A, Influential Person, B, Brave Person, C, Centering Tribes of Mortals, and D, None of These. The correct answer is of course C, and that is, he calls himself as Centering Tribes of Mortals. Question number 6 we have, according to Goldsmith, Germans were drunken sots and dash. Options are A, courageous, B, sporty, C, selfless, and D, beastly gluttons. Correct answer is D, and it is beastly gluttons. The next question, question number 7 we have, prejudice means what? Options are A, an unfair opinion or hate without reason, B, approach, C, perception, and D,
none of these. Correct answer is of course A, and it is an unfair opinion or hate without reason. Question number 8 we have. Goldsmith says Dutch were apostle of dash. Options are A, bravery, B, encouragement, C, avaricious riches, and D, flattering sycophants. The correct answer is C, and that is avaricious riches. Question number 9 we have. According to Goldsmith, French are most temperate and dash. Options are A, aggressive, B, polite, C, brave, and D, patient. Correct answer is B, that is polite. Question number 10 we have. According to Goldsmith, Germans are more hardy and dash. Options are A, brave, B, fatigue, C, patient, and D, stead. The correct answer is C, and it is patient. Hardy and patient. Question number 11 we have. The story is narrated in dash point of view. Options are A, first person, B, second person, C, third person, and D, none of these. The correct answer is A, and it is narrated in first person's point of view. Question number 12 we have. National Prejudices first published in dash. Options are A, 1760, B, 1761, C, 1762, and D, 1763. The correct answer is A, and it was first published in 1760. Question number 13 we have. Goldsmith argues that it is possible to love one's own country without dash. Options are A, hating others, B, hating the natives of other countries, C, loving the natives of other countries, and D, loving others. Correct answer is of course B, and it is without hating the natives of other countries. Question number 14 we have. Earlier Goldsmith talks about the concept of dash. Options are A, citizen of the city, B, citizen of the country, C, citizen of the nation, and D, citizen of the world. The correct answer is D, of course, and it is the citizen of the world. We have the next question, question number 15. Earlier Goldsmith says, we are now become so much dash. Options are A, Englishmen, Frenchmen, Dutchmen, Spaniards, or Germans. B, Englishmen, C, Frenchmen, and D, human being. The correct answer is of course A, and Oliver Goldsmith says we are now become so much Englishmen, Frenchmen, Dutchmen, Spaniards, or Germans. Question number 16 we have. The narrator says that we no longer consider ourselves as the dash. Options are A, citizen of the globe, B, general inhabitants of the globe, C, citizen of the city, and D, none of these. Correct answer is B, and it is general inhabitants of the globe. Question number 17 we have. Who are those most apt to boast of national merit according to Goldsmith? Options are A, who have no caliber of their own, B, who have caliber of their own, C, who have merit of their own, and D, who have no merit of their own. Correct answer is D, and it is who have no merit of their own. Question number 18 we have. Dash and dash are the growth of religion according to the narrator. Options are A, superstition and faith, B, superstition and enthusiasm, C, enthusiasm and faith, and D, none of these. The correct answer is B, and it is superstition and enthusiasm are the growth of religion according to the narrator or Oliver Goldsmith. Question number 19. Without despising all the rest of the world as dash. Options A, fallacy and delusion, B, heroic and brave, C, cards and poltroons, and D, none of these. Correct answer is of course C, and it is cards and poltroons. Question number 20 we have. The Vicar of Wakefield is a dash by Oliver Goldsmith. Options are A, play, B, novel, C, prose, and D, poem. Correct answer is B, and The Vicar of Wakefield is a novel by Oliver Goldsmith. Question number 21 we have, Oliver Goldsmith's The Deserted Village is a dash. Options are A. Ode, B. Elegy, C. Pastoral Poem, and D. Prose. Correct answer is C. And Oliver Goldsmith's The Deserted Village is a renowned pastoral poem. Question number 22 we have, Oliver Goldsmith died on dash. Options are 3rd April 1774, B. 4th April 1774, C. 14th April 1774, and D. 13th April 1774. The correct answer is B, and he died on 4th April 1774. Question number 23 we have, Germans were drunken sots and beastly gluttons. What does gluttons mean? Options are A. One who overindulges in dreams. B. One who overindulges in drink. C. One who overindulges in food. And D. One who overindulges in food or drink. The correct answer is D. And gluttons means one who overindulges in food or drink. Question number 24 we have, Spaniards or Spaniard means what? Options are A. A native or inhabitant of England. B. A native or inhabitant of Spain. C. A native or inhabitant of France. And D. None of these. The correct answer is of course B. And Spaniard means a native or inhabitant of Spain. Next question. Question number 25. In bravery, generosity, clemency, and in every other virtue, the dash excelled all the rest of the world, according to the narrator or Oliver Goldsmith. Options are A. Germans, B. French, C. English, and D. Indians. The correct answer is C, and it is English. Question number 26 we have, dash proud, haughty, and surely tyrants, according to the narrator. Options are A. Spaniards, B. Indians, C. Germans, and D. Dutch. The correct answer is A, and it is Spaniards. So friends, all these are the multiple choice questions based on Oliver Goldsmith's well-known prose called National Prejudices. I hope friends you have liked all the multiple choice questions discussed in this video, in this presentation. And if you have really liked it, then I request you to like it, share it among your friends, near and dear ones as well. Friends, if you are a new viewer to this channel and if you have not subscribed this channel yet, then I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this channel in the coming days. So friends, I ensure you will meet soon again with a different video on different piece of literature. Till then friends, just take care of yourself and be happy. Thank you very much.